hope to the hurting world. Global Evangelical Church presents to you our service. Please enjoy. Our senior pastor, Reverend John Baker Katende, and his wife, Pastor Robina Katende, welcome you to the Global Evangelical family.
Through some of it all, but through it all. Paul tells us that in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Pastor Robert, you are telling us how Sister Jolene, wait a little while. Before she tells us she's 18, remember you intend to do that like you don't know. But she's going to be a married woman. But one time we went to visit with my wife in the hospital when she had just come in the world, and she was this much, like this much. Many tears fell on her, that little girl. But through it all, now, there are many stories in here about what God has taken you through. If all of us were to testify about where God has gotten us from, it will take forever. Amen. And that should always be an engine for all of us, is that he who took us through that. You remember that? You remember that time? Some of us forget so easily. But David says, bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not. That's the problem. We forget. Amen. Now, you saw these people here. Somebody says, I thank God. My God is good. But not every day is going to be like that. Now, this is the truth for some of you. Why should you say that? It's not going to be. But I want you, Ronnie, and to remember at least today that one time we stood and I said, I thank God. Because sometimes you say, did she come from the Lord? Oh, she must. Did he come from the Lord? But through it all, we ought to learn to depend on he who said that it is not good knows about those times when it doesn't look too good. Amen. but through it all, I want to tell you that God knows it all. If you still have any doubt about that statement, speak it to yourself again. I don't have. Tell yourself that God knows it all. Tell yourself. Don't tell your neighbor, because many a time we tell you. Tell your neighbor. Tell yourself today that God knows it all. 8 years ago, Mama Harriet came to the U.S. and left a daughter in Uganda. 8 years ago. And they may have tried this, that, and the other. But in the fullness of time, she's standing with us, say, I am here with my mother. Through it all. Now that story is repeated many a time here. I don't know where Mr. Florence. Florence is the happiest lady in this church, if you don't know. Some of you wonder why she smiles when she goes. In the fullness of time, God brought the young man that she had left in Uganda. Through it all, God knows it all. There was a young man, I'm just testifying. His name is Paul Kalimongabo, the biggest man in Singapore. Paul Kalimongabo, we spend many hours in the office about his stories, about papers, about things going archaic, and nothing is working out. But one time he was before the magistrate, and he had told nobody to come with him except his wife. And there entered a man with a Bible in the courthouse. And the judge asked, how about that? And the man said, I am his pastor. And he sat down. And nobody asked him, what is a pastor doing in the church? And somehow, somewhere, the judge was turned to the side of Paul to plead for him. The judge was pleading for Paul in front of the prosecutors, and the prosecutor, what's going on? And then the hammer came, boom! I give the man. So they go out of the courthouse. And as Paul is turning to his wife to say that this man said that, where is he? And he was no more. Now some of you are looking at me and this. In the fullness of time, God is going to make you smile. Oh! In the fullness of time, God is going to give you a song of praise. You know, some of you see us sing and you wonder, how come? You try, because there are certain things that are sitting on your heart, on your life, and you can't even raise up a voice to sing. But we are told of a widow, the one in 2 Kings chapter 4. Is that the one we're talking about? She had debts, and the debtor had come to sell the children. Now, can you tell such a woman to sing? You can't. But when God performed the miracle and she had enough for herself even to sell to pay the debt, now she could sing. There is a day that God is bringing in your life, and you are going to sing a song of praise unto the name of the Lord. Did I say we have stories? I'm not going to tell about myself. But I mean, I have stories. Maybe who came to my office? And you know, it was migration again. I don't know why I'm talking about migration. Maybe somebody here needs to do that. You know, she had come here, and then she went back to Uganda, but even before she went back to Uganda, she had tried to do things, and she had had a driver's license, and when she went to Uganda, things didn't work out for her to come back, so she changed the names and came back with another passport, and then she goes, she asked for whatever status, then they give her, and then she goes to ask for the driver's license again. You know, and then they give her the driver's license, but before that, they take a picture for her. And these computers are wise. When the computer saw the picture of the girl, it remembered there is another picture that looks like that woman. And then, boom, two pictures, different names. And the woman said, hey, excuse me. You know her? One sweat, you know, just one sweat. Ever seen anybody sweat? Just one. And they say, oh, it's not that good. Then, long story short, she was called to go to the migration office, and then she told her friends, are you mad? Just get to the next plane, or bus, or boat, or fly, or do whatever it means to get out of here. And she came to the office and said, what do you lose? Now, if you want to take yourself away, why don't you allow them to take you? You just go to the office. The worst they will say is go away. And they have told you to go away anyway. So, when she left the office, I said, did I advise her wisely? Are people going to blame me for this? And she went to the migration. She gave her a very big, tall man to take her through. Yeah. And when she was entering, you know, those gates, grand, till she sat down. And the man got on the computer. And as he was typing, the girl fell down on her knees and said, forgive me, sir. The man said, I'm doing my job. What's going on? You know, this is what I did. I know what you did. I'm putting it right. She's a citizen as I speak. God knows it all. He knows our failures. He knows our mistakes. He knows our sins. He knows our worries. He knows our... What I didn't mention, he knows it. He knows what I don't know. He knows the report that the doctor has given you. He knows it. You know, our theme for this year is they that know their God. But it is hard to trust a God who you don't know that he knows about you. So we need, first of all, to know that God knows about us and cares about everything about us so that we can fully trust him. And then we'll be strong in the Lord and even in the power of his might. Then we can do exploits. But when you haven't known about this God, amen, do you think there is a time when you need to grow up and start laughing at certain problems, despising them, just despising them? I'm told of a preacher. You know, preachers get the name. But one time he was reading his Bible and preparing for message, and then he heard his bed shaking. And then it was moved to some distance. And then he was perturbed. And then the Spirit of God revealed to him that it was the devil trying to disturb him. And then he, oh, it is you. And then he continued with his stuff. But then he remembered, the bed was moved. No, This bed has to go back where it was.
And it was moved back.
I mean, we have to grow in the Lord and come to a fullness of knowledge and trust and faith in God that we won't be moved. Tears don't cut it. Those tears you cried last night, you are going to be dehydrated for nothing. Worries don't cut it. What I'm telling you today, as I was leaning here, let me say it again. God does it all. If you forget everything that you are going to say in these 2 minutes, remember this. Young lady, young man, judge in this place, husband, wife, mother, father, businessman, student, minister of the word of God, whoever you are, God knows it all. He knows the end from the beginning. Everything in between. It doesn't matter how long it has taken. It's already told to us. Book of Exodus. Children of Israel find themselves in Egypt and they stay there for quite a time. 400 years. Indeed. 10 years. But now 400 years is not little time. Amen. But God was still on the throne. When they were being tormented, when they were being despised, when they were being abused, when they were crying out, when some of them were dying, God was still on the throne. Because in 400 years, people are born and people die, people are born and people die. Amen. Let's go to Exodus. Chapter 2 and verse 23 to 25. Exodus chapter 2, verse 23. Now it happened in the process of that time, the king of Egypt died. When the children of Israel groaned because of the bondage, and they cried out, and their cry came up to God because of their bondage. Now, there is a cry unto God, and there is a cry which is, woe unto me, poor me, who is going to help me? Oh, I wish I was not born. Oh, I wish I was not a man. I wish I never got married to that man. I wish I was a kid again. I wish I never came to U.S. I wish I never left my children wherever I left. I wish I never met that woman. I wish I never took this course. Now that's another cry. But there is a cry unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. There is a cry that we can lift up unto God. The Bible says, whoever calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And God hears, by the way. God sees. God remembers. God knows it all. He knows the good, he knows the bad, and he knows the ugly of life. He knows me thoroughly well, more than I know myself. And he knows you thoroughly. He knows what is going on even right now. Some of you are like me, you have put on so nicely, and you looked into the mirror and
Newewe Chigaro. And here you are. I have learned to trust in Jesus, to God. But deep inside you, you are even asking yourself, what am I saying? Does he care about me? Does he know about me? But these people cried unto God. And their cry came up to God because of their bondage. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what you are going through. And I don't know what you are about to go through. And I don't know what you have just come out of. Because we are like that. You are either going into it, or you are just coming out of it, or you are in it. Amen. So if you are not in it, you better prepare. Uh-oh, what a preacher. You should tell us it is the peace. It is the, everything is all right. If I have to be truthful with you, be alert. Because the enemy is rolling like a lion, moving around back and forth, and he has you on his mind. Because he doesn't come from home unless he has a target to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus has come that we may have life and have it more abundantly. And there is a package for you for that abundance waiting somewhere. Verse 24. So God, because of their cry unto the Lord, because of their bondage, the Bible is telling us God heard their groaning. And God remembered his covenant with Abraham and with Isaac and Jacob. Verse 25. And God looked upon the children of Israel and acknowledged them. Other Bibles tell us that he knew what they were going through. He knows, he acknowledged their troubles. He knew. And he's not only knowing and remembering and seeing and hearing. He has a plan. Oh. You know, I can see what you are going through. And I even put my hand on my cheek with you. I can even hear, but I have no plan. Planless. You even ask me, Pastor, what can we do? Because I have come to the end of how much I can do. But my God, my Redeemer, the Savior of Israel, the Creator of the universe, the Sustainer of everything, God who created the sun and put it in place, and the stars, and separated the water, he who makes a way where there is no way, God knows about him. And he has a plan for you. Knowing that is treasure. Knowing that somebody is looking out for me. Knowing that God cares is strength itself. For Paul tells us that in all these things, we are more than conquerors. We are. Amen. Verse chapter 3 of the same book. Verse 7 and 8. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the oppression of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cry because of their taskmasters. For I know, then said God knows it all, I know their sorrow. Come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden. And I will give you rest. I don't know who's crying among us because of what you have heard, because of what you are going through, because of what the Lord, because Pharaoh had told the taskmasters to double the work that they were supposed to do, and not even to give them the grass, whatever they call it. So, right? Straw. Not the grass, but straw. To make bricks. He said, now if we supply the straw, you have a lot of time to just sit around. We are not going to give you the straw. You are going to collect your straw and make the same amount of bricks. That is a sorrow which God knows about. And I've heard, like I don't hear, that there are laws out there that are being tightened about people who are here. And everybody is on their toes. Have you heard? Did you know? My God, what are we going to do? What should we do? Is Canada open? Here. God knows it all. He who opened the door for you to come here didn't throw you through the window and then left. He is with you all the way. All the way. I told you he has a plan. In chapter 2, we saw him. He had heard the cry of his people. Now in chapter 3, we see the plan. He's telling Moses, I have heard. Musa, I have heard. I have heard. There is a Moses there in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Our Moses is Jesus these days, beloved. Glory to God. He's our Redeemer. He's our Savior. And he has told us that he will never leave us nor forsake us. He is with us until the end of this age. When you enter into a task and he has started it, he is with you to the end. Don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Praise God. Some hardships are good for us. How so? To strengthen you. To teach you how to fight. To learn to depend on God. To teach you to pray. To develop trust and faith in God. To give you a testimony that you can glorify God in the midst of many people. Some things come that way, that God may be glorified. So not every test is for your calamity. No. All things, when you come to know God thoroughly, then you can speak like the one who wrote in all things work out together for good. That is Paul, Roman. All things in 8:29. All things work out together for good. Let's read. Let's read. You know, faith comes by hearing. Amen. And hearing the word of God. He says, for who he foreknew and also predestined to be conformed to the image of God, of his Son, that he might be the first among many brethren. Go on. Is it 28? Let's read. For we know, yes, 28. For we know that all things, how many things? Did you hear yourself saying all? How many things? Please be obedient only to them. Can you say all? For your good. All things. Not a few. All things, beloved. all things pertaining life, all things pertaining the church, all things pertaining the family, all things pertaining your marriage, all things pertaining your children, all things pertaining your business, your past, your present, your future, all things work out together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. God has a purpose for your life. And it takes you through training. It takes you through circumstances. Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord, beloved. So, I don't know what you are going through, but count it joy. Count to be joy for whatever it is that you are going through. You may not understand it now, but you will understand it better by and by. Amen. God took the children of Israel from Egypt to the promised land, and it is a long journey, long story there. You know the miracles, you know the resistances that they went through. It is the God is the same. He who was with the Israels is with us. Your journey may have hindrances and obstacles and enemies and waters and fires, but he says when you go through rivers, through waters and through fires, do not fear, for I am with you. He is with us. So that's why when people find me in that office at 34, I am joyful. When people come swelling, thinking, and they touch me crying. Catch me crying because I have poised a big project. It's not my project. And I can't carry it on my head. If I did, you would see me no more. But he who started it will accomplish it. Amen. Resistances may come. Hindrances may come. Pharaoh may organize an army to come after me or you. Because you have escaped, beloved. You have escaped from where the devil expected to meet you. And when he came to check on you, you were not there. And he wondered where you had gone. And they told him that you had accepted Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Just like the children of Israel were leaving Egypt to go and worship God, we are also leaving whatever we were doing to go and serve God. And the devil doesn't like it a single bit. That gives him ulcers. Knowing that you are worshiping God, that you are joyful, that you are giving a testimony to God, that you are telling the whole world that 8 years I was in Uganda and my mother was there and I longed to see her, and now, lo and behold, I am with her. The devil heard it and is going to test that faith. Mama. Don't be surprised if I see you become lovely. One of these days to say, did I make the right decision to come here? My God, why did I even ever think of coming here? We have seen before, but we are still here. And God is still working. And better days are yet to come. He who started it will accomplish it. You may come to a sea and you have been running. You thought you had outrun the man. And all of a sudden, you have blocked the waters. I'm talking about the children of Israel. They come to the waters. They can't swim. But there are many. They thought maybe a simple thought would say, why don't we drink it? I don't know whether they tried. glasses of water as a good as you can drink, juice, or tea. But water, I don't know about water. But the water was there. But he who had started the journey knew about the water, and he had a plan for the water. I'm saying that he who brought you, because you are the chosen of God, as we read it, for those that love God, and he has called according to, God called you according, not to our purpose, not your purpose, his purpose. He knows what he's doing in your life. He knows the plan. There is a way he's going to sneak you through. And before you know it, you will be on the other side, praising God. As I look on that side, I see Brother Sebo with a smile from here to here. Some people wonder why he sings like he sings. He has a vision. Talking about Robert Sebo. Now there is a Juniard, Brother Sebo. The man can sing, and then you see him doing the feet of this. Tomorrow is yours. I'm telling you. I am telling you. Whatever it is, beloved, God knows about it. So what should we do? We should cry unto the Lord. We should take our problems to the Lord. Then I was listening to the radio, and I heard somebody say that many of us take our problems to people. And the statistics say that 90% don't care. 90% of the people you tell your problem don't care. And they say that the 10% that are remaining are glad you have them. I don't know if that's that. 90% of the people you tell your problems. I mean, what? They don't tell you. You know they tell you to listen. Oh. And as soon as you're gone, like I care. And then the 10%. Remain. Then what did you think? You know, you used to tell them, and you're glad now you're experiencing it. But there is somebody who cares. Somebody who knows about it. Somebody who has a plan for you to give you hope and a future. The God who makes a way where there is no way. The God who sits with us in the fire, in the rivers, and in the waters. The God who goes with us even when we go through the darkest valley of the shadow of death. He is with us. The God that David spoke about, that they that trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. God who is spoken about in Psalms 46, that the Lord is our strength, our refuge, and an ever-present help in time of trouble. A God that David talks about in Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. A God that Jesus Christ exhorts us to call upon, our Father. I commend you to this champion. I commend you to this lover of men. I commend you to call upon the Lord, for whoever calls upon the name of the Lord. Let me find my last verse here. Chapter 34 of Psalms, verse 17. Yes. Let me see.
The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears, and delivers them out of all their troubles. I pray that I may learn to take my problems where they dwell. I pray that I may learn. And it's my prayer that you will cry unto the Lord. I know your testimonies. You have cried unto the Lord. Oh, as I look through, I see testimonies. I see people that God has bailed out on the 11th hour. On the 11th hour. These testimonies are full of my... Somebody was taken to New York to be boarded in a plane. Deportation. Everything is finished. You know these sheriff trucks? They are covered and they take you. You don't see nowhere. It's all dark, and the person was there, and they sit him in a room waiting to be called. And the sheriff is looking, and the papers are not in him. They are in Boston. The papers, how can a sheriff forget? And the plane can't take anybody. Insufficient papers. They bring her back to Boston. Is out in the streets as I speak. Now, do you think people come and tell you what you say? Not only a quick story. So, beloved, you are the next one to come to tell us in the office that God has done it, that God has come through. Let me lean again here and let you know.
Trust in Jesus. I have learned to trust in God. Through it all. Through it all. I have learned to depend upon His word. Through it all. Through it all. Through it all. Through it all. I have learned. Through it all, through it all,
my brother, my sister, God sends his word and heals us. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. Now without faith, we can please God as we trust him today. Without faith, we cannot. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. Now that faith comes to us through the word that we love. Heart. The God of Israel, the God who took the children of Israel through the waters and fought their battles and gave them manna from above, even meat. He who sustained them with no sewing machines, even shops to buy stuff. The God who told them that I am with you, being led by Moses through the desert. I don't know whether you know about deserts. Life is brutal in desert. So it doesn't matter how brutal life may be in your life, in your home, in your situation. God is with you. I want you to take a to surrender all your problems. To cry out unto the Lord, even as the children of Israel cry out unto the Lord. To cast your burdens and fears and worries unto the Lord, who has promised to sustain you. Today is your day. The other day was a day for Israel. It was a day for Jeremiah. It was a day for Daniel. It was a day for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. It was a day for the widow that we heard about. It was a day for Zacchaeus. Today is your day. So raise your hand now. And you know your situation. We love you. Lift that voice up. Heart, he knows, he understands, he cares, and he has come down to help you out by sending you the word to call upon you to trust him. Father, in the name of Jesus, we commit ourselves in your hands. We are weak, but thou art strong. We can't do everything, but with you all things are possible. We lift every situation, every circumstance, every challenge, every worry, every fear, every sickness, every disease, every hindrance, oh God, every enemy, every need, every debt, everything that pertains to our life that is not according to the plan that you have for us, Lord, we commit it into your hands right now. We pray that the Lord will hear our prayer and remember us and care about this, because our God cares. Other people may have tried to help us, and we have come to the end of what we can do. But that's not the end of us, oh God. You are God who surpasses the understanding of you. Your thoughts are far above what you can do. And the Bible told us that you can do. You can do exceed abundantly. Beyond what we think or even us. So tonight we want to trust you. For that woman that is sick. For that man that needs you, oh God. For that daughter, for that son, for that need, for that problem, for that job, for that debt, oh God, for that relative that is suffering, for those that have called us with problems that we can't handle, for those that are looking unto us, oh God, we turn our eyes unto you and we point every need to you, the God who sustains the universe. And we thank you, because when we cry out, the Bible told us that the righteous to call upon the Lord, and the Lord hears their prayer, and he delivers them in all their troubles, and in time any powers of the enemy that threaten us, that make us to fear. We break those powers in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And we commit ourselves to thy name. There is nothing that you cannot do. For you have told us in your word that I am the Lord God of all flesh. Is there anything to be taken from you? We do it very well. So and we bless you. We thank you for 30-fold in our son. For it is a done deal by your power and your might and your providence. For you make a way where there is no way. We commit this week in your hands, that we will see the goodness of the Lord in this land of the living, and that when we see each other again, Lord will thank you. We will give you all the glory. We thank you for Sister Sarah Senoga, who was in the hospital, but now she's at home. Oh God, strengthen her in the name of the Lord. And everyone that is sick, we pray for healing in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. And our brothers and sisters who should have been with us today and are not, wherever they are, oh God, we commit them in your hands. Oh, we pray that we will always gather together to worship you, to praise you, to honor you, and to give you all the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. And everybody say, amen and amen. Amen and amen. To the glory of God. Hallelujah. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. The man I had that he lived to live with Chairman Mr. Mugwanya sent me to say hello to you, to remind you of the India project. Friends of India, see Mr. Mugwanya with $10 for this month. Amen. Amen.
Please, I'm about the Friends of India.